That's Bill Baker.
In all his glory.
Our next speaker here is Bill Baker. He's a retired sheriff's investigator from Santa Barbara County who began working homicide in late 1970. Soon after his arrival in the unit, he was assigned a cold case, that of a teenaged couple found shot to death in a lean-to shack by a secluded Pacific Ocean beach in June of 1963. During the course of reworking the case, Bill became aware of striking similarities between the 1963 case and that of the fatal attack on a couple at Lake Berryessa in Napa County in September of 1969. That began a search for what appeared to him to be the same killer in both cases, which Bill continues to this day. Bill Baker.
Our paths crossed with Zodiac when I was working this 1963 case that David had described. And because of similarities with the case in Lake Berryessa in 1969, it became evident to me that it bore more than just a little bit of looking into. I received this as a cold case when I was first going into working homicides late 1970. The victims involved in our case in 1963, Robert George Domingos and Linda Faye Edwards, they were 18 and 17 years respectively, and they were found piled together in a primitively constructed lean-to shack that was nestled into the oak trees at the edge of the beach just north of Santa Barbara. From what we've been able to piece together, and this is speculative, I have to admit that, because obviously there's no witnesses to this. Bobby and Linda were seniors at Long Polk High School, and they had less than a week to go before they were to graduate from the high school, and they had taken advantage of the senior ditch day to go be alone at a secluded beach. They'd been there previously, so they knew that they could go there unmolested. So Bobby parked his Pontiac on the turnout just off of the southbound lanes of U.S. Highway 101. They walked down a kind of steep path to the beach below. They were resting on a blanket spread out near the beach, near the water, dressed in bathing suits, when they were approached by a man with a gun, probably a rifle. Now, in the moments that followed, the man produced pre-cut lengths of rope and directed Linda to tie Bobby's hands together, after which the man then began to tie Linda's hands. Apparently, because Linda had not tied Bobby's hands securely, he was able to break free and somehow overpower the man with a gun, at least long enough for he and Linda to be able to take off running at the creek bed away from the beach. The man started firing at them as they ran, and they both went down. We believe he probably reloaded before he approached them, because altogether, just the bullets that hit the body themselves would have been more than a rifle would have been able to hold in a magazine. In any event, he walked up to them and pumped bullets into each of them until he was sure they were dead. He then dragged Bobby's body to the lean-to shack that was just a short distance away, threw him in there, and then went back and dragged Linda also into the shack, throwing her on top of Bobby. Apparently the guy tried to set fire to the shack. There was a blanket that covered the entrance, and it had scorch marks on it, plus there was matches that were found, burnt matches. He had put it most of their belongings, such as the other clothes they had and their blanket and other things inside the shack. And his intention, I believe, was just to burn all the evidence. But again, it was a futile effort. At some point, I decided to send out a teletype to California law enforcement agencies, just basically detailing our crime from 1963. And again, this was 7 or 8 years later, 8 years at least, when I sent out the teletype, just asking for anyone that had any similars, and this was just within California. That same day, I got two calls. The first one was from San Francisco Police Department Homicide Inspector Bill Armstrong, who told me, in his opinion, our case was that of Zodiac. And he said, in fact, that after reviewing the details of the crime, he would never think about Zodiac cases again without including Santa Barbara in that. The second call was from Dave Struve, that's S-T-R-U-V-E, who was a crime analyst with the state of California, the CINI, which is the Criminal Investigation Identification Bureau. And he had also worked with Mel Nicolai, whose job was basically to coordinate all of these Zodiac cases for all the various agencies. Dave echoed basically what Bill Armstrong had said, that it looks like a Zodiac case. So from that point on, once I was able to talk to most of the investigators that were originally assigned to the Zodiac cases, and also to just study the cases themselves. But the one that stood out, of course, was the Lake Berryessa case, because of the similarities there. And any of you that know about Lake Berryessa would know what kind of similarities I'm talking about. But since that time, I've been a believer in Zodiac being the person responsible for killing Bobby and Linda in 1963, and I'm still a believer. He was into nighttime blitz attacks, and for him to do it in daytime where he could be seen, he had to hide behind it, because he didn't like face-to-face confrontation. So in hiding behind the mask and having the glasses, it offered him some protection.
But what you were saying about the hood, though, that he, you know, did he wear it for something that he got out of it,
right.
or did he wear it because he enjoyed the fear that it instilled in people?
That's another
element.
That's
much more frightening than a ski mask.
That's another element, I'm sure, but I think there might have well have been elements of not only the fear that it would instill in them, but also because of whatever satisfaction, whether it's because of part of his fantasy. Most serial killers are terrorists to a certain extent, and the fact that with his letters and whatnot, where he was trying to instill terror in people, fear. So I'm sure he got off in a certain amount of fear as well.